The fiscal cliff negotiations proceeding filled with the rumor, conjecture about what's happened. There are some facts we know. Obama's apparently gone from 250,000 to 400,000.
But again, I don't, just be careful about calling it a fact, because there's the presentation of the 400,000. That there's nothing before any Congress or any.
No, but I mean, you read the right, but you read the in the. It seems clear Obama has gone to 400,000.
That he has a flexibility there, which is to that.
We're in negotiations. Yeah. He could take it back.
Of course.
Right. So right now he's gone to 400,000.
But the bigger story.
Yeah, the bigger story then are the cuts made to Social Security. Harry Reid said, essentially, mark my words, Social Security will not be part of this deal, but it appears that at least at this stage, it is on the table. Michael, what is the... That
Barack Obama seems to be moving that way, and go ahead, give us the info.
You know, the Associated Press went with a story citing people close to these negotiations, saying that, in fact, what they were talking about are the cost of living adjustments, known as COLAs, which they go through an inflation. So as the cost of living gets higher, so too do the allotments that people on Social Security get. Those cost of living adjustments are now in play, which is to stop the inflation on those cuts so that they don't go up commensurate with the cost, the actual cost of living, which is a deal breaker for a lot of Democrats. MoveOn.org, for example, the progressive activists are saying that they are imploring no Democrat in the Senate or in the House to do anything to support anything that has these COLAs attached to them.
Now let's talk about that. What the average amount of Social Security that someone receives now is $1,230 a month, right? So that's roughly less than $15,000 a year.
My mother gets $1,191.86, and she will tell you that amount in every conversation.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. So that's what's happening right now, and they want to slow the growth of that, the increases that would be tied to inflation. They right. want to slow that. So let me just make...
But also, just slow that growth, that's a cut.
That's
that
a
means,
cut.
That means that you're not going to get as much money from Social Security
right.
in 3 years as you would have gotten.
In 5 years, your Social Security payment that you get from the government will have less buying power than it does now.
Yeah, it's like rent stabilization in a way, right. and the opposite. It's like being the landlord in rent stabilization, right. where you cannot raise the rent, even that 5% that is guaranteed by law. Well, they're not going to get that cost of living adjustment, no matter what it is. However,
and real quick, though, the story is suggesting also that it will be sort of slow rolled in. That while the cuts, there'll be minimal cuts in the next 3, 4, 5 years, but then those cuts or the lack of an increase accelerate down the road.
But also protected within this, and we're going with this story that is being talked about right now, but nobody's seen it in writing. The one thing to take from this is that these cuts will not affect people of a lower financial class, a lower economic class.
So
they're going to protect those cost of living adjustments. They're going to go up for people of lower class income.
Okay, so you're saying that they will continue to calculate the inflation rate for lower income people who are on Social Security?
Yes, but
what do they consider lower income,
exactly.
and what they consider?
That of course hasn't been defined. I can't define it. I don't know how they're going to go about it.
But of course, this all makes sense because this is exactly the kind of thing Obama campaigned on: cutting Social Security.
Right. As a matter of fact, the vice president guaranteed during the campaign that they would not include Social Security. Social Security does not need to be part of this. It is a totally different discussion. Harry Reid, the majority leader, has said during his last election, I believe, I don't want to talk about Social Security for 20 years because we don't need to. Richard Durbin is now saying, he is the second in command in the Senate for the Democrats, he's saying, absolutely not. We're not going to entertain anything that has to do with Social Security.
What's Nancy Pelosi saying?
Nancy Pelosi is saying the exact same. She's saying that the House is going to stick together against Plan B. She had something interesting. We'll talk about Plan B as well. She had something interesting to say about the way the Republicans are going ahead with their trying to get a vote on what they're calling Plan B, which is another way of going about this, circumventing the White House, in essence. She's saying, well, in this Plan B, they're already conceding on the idea of raising tax rates. So she sees that the Republicans are raising tax rates. If she sees that, she's going to say, well, I don't want to do this spending. She's saying, absolutely not. We cannot touch Social Security. So this could be a way, I mean, for the last bit of analysis here, this could be a way that the White House is saying, all right, let's let this guy talk to the AP. If we allow the Democrats to really react, and we are reacting with our caucus, and what comes out eventually, this is of course pie in the sky by me, mm-hmm. but if what comes out eventually doesn't have these Social Security cuts to them or these COLA adjustments, then it'll seem like the president is in lockstep with his Congress, which is what they want. They want to present a unified front.
Okay, I'll just make the point again that this is not Barack Obama and Vice President. They campaigned on the exact opposite of this,
right.
And this is coming at a time when everyone knows now. Who pays attention that Social Security does not drive the debt. Everybody knows that except for Maria Buttafuoco from CNBC. And so in a time we have the stock market's back to make record highs, corporations are back to making record profits, sitting on $5 trillion at some estimates. We're still funding an Afghan war, which 73% of Americans are against, to a tune of $2 billion a week, $100 billion a year. We're giving banks $40 to $50 trillion a month in quantitative easing. That's free money. But how are we going to take care of our financial hole? We're going to push some old people in it.
No,
that's what we have to do. And you know what this is? This is exactly what a plutocracy looks like.